Hi, my name is Nicole, the Wellness Genie. I'm a registered nurse, a certified nutrition health coach, and an eco-consultant. Today I'm going to explain to you what kind of fats you should eat and which ones you should avoid. What I have to tell you may surprise you, so keep listening. Let's jump into a very brief chemistry lesson. Fats are composed of fatty acids, which are a chemical structure made of hydrogen and carbon. There are three basic types of fats: saturated, monounsaturated, and polyunsaturated. Saturated fats means that all the carbon bonds are filled with a hydrogen atom, hence the name saturated. The fatty acid is saturated with hydrogen. This makes the chemical structure rigid and very stable, like this, a straight line. An example of a saturated fat is butter. It is solid at room temperature. Monounsaturated fats have one double bond, hence the name mono, between two carbons and therefore lack two hydrogens. These are not saturated with hydrogen and therefore have a kink in their structure where that hydrogen is missing. So they look sort of like this. These oils are liquid at room temperature but become solid in the fridge, and they're fairly stable fats. An example is olive oil. Polyunsaturated fats have two or more double bonds and are missing four or more hydrogens, and they look like this. This makes the chemical structure highly unstable, and it easily can break at all the bends, or in chemical language, the double bonds. Vegetable oils are polyunsaturated fats. Enough about chemistry. So what does this all mean for you? Heat from cooking can break down the chemical structure of polyunsaturated fats, which makes them go rancid. Rancid oils wreak chemical havoc on a cellular level and contribute to diseases like cancer. So you never want to cook with vegetable oils like canola, soy, safflower, or sunflower. What you do want to use for cooking are stable fats, like the saturated fats. These stable fats include butter, lard, tallow, palm oil, and coconut oil. Remember, these have a very stable chemical structure with no weak bends, and they will not break down when exposed to heat. And as an added benefit, they make your food taste delicious. What about olive oil? I know we hear a lot about that in the press. Olive oil is a monounsaturated fat, and it is fairly stable. This means it's great for salads and okay for low temperature cooking, but you never want to fry anything in olive oil. That heat would be too high and would cause the oil to go rancid. Vegetable oils should not be exposed to any heat, so you should only use them in salad dressings. The truth is, I don't have any vegetable oils in my house. They contain a high level of omega-6 essential fatty acids, which is a whole other topic of discussion. But in short, omega-6 essential fatty acids are overconsumed in our American diet, and this leads to molecular imbalances in our bodies. So in summary, you should cook with butter, tallow, palm oil, coconut oil, and my personal favorite, lard. I promise you, eating saturated fats will not make you gain weight. You should use olive oil in your salad dressings, and you want to avoid vegetable oils. Thank you for watching, and if you learned something, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it with your friends. You can connect with me on Facebook and at my website, www.thewellnessgenie.com.